Fitzgerald trying to get around Samuelson, who slowed up. Gave Taglianetti a chance to play the puck toward Brian Trotche. Trotche for the Penguins. Samuelson moved it on to Mullen. To Bourque, who was trying to drive to the net. Norton over him. It's centered. And back to the blue line. Here's Paul Coffey with a drive. The bang and the rebound. Phil Bourque wins it for the Penguins in OT.
What a tough break after Randy Wood had hit the crossbar. Coffey feeds it through. Bourque taps it in. And it's a 7-6 Pittsburgh win in overtime. They scored 5 straight goals.
Some comeback for this Pittsburgh team. Lollygag through the first half and more of this game. And Al Arbor sees his team twice give up 4 goal leads and suffer their first loss on home ice this season as the Penguins. On a goal by Phil Bourque, win it in overtime. Another look at it, Ed.
Let's take another look in the center ice area. They grabbed possession of the puck. Mullen dumped it in. I believe that's Phil Bourque in the corner. Yes, he backhands it to the front of the net. The Islanders try to clear it. They don't. Coffey grabs it. Coffey winds up, blasts it. There it is. Laying out in front of the net, sliding it in is Bourque. Jeff Norton standing beside him.
An assist on the goal by Coffey ties him with Islander great Denny Potvin for the most assists. He is now 1 point behind Potvin's all-time record. Would you think how close the Islanders came in this game, Ed?
You can't come any closer. Right at the junction of crossbar and post, here's Randy Wood as he tees it up, lets it fly. There it is, rising, and it hit to the left of the goaltender. There, right at the junction point. Then it came out, just missing it is Ray Ferraro. Had he been moved back just a little bit, he'd have had time to grab it in an open net. That's how close the Islanders came to winning the game.
The only assist on the game winner goes to Coffey, Bourque's second of the season, and in overtime. Your final score is the Pittsburgh Penguins 7, the New York Islanders 6. Back with a wrap-up from the Nassau Coliseum following these messages.